Hey, welcome back to the stream. This is Last Gen Gamers, where you're always the right age to game. And we are continuing on with our Resonant Rise from the Ashes series. And tonight I'm going to be joined, of course, by A. Bowick. And we're jumping back onto the server here to see what's happened since we've been gone. And it's been a couple of days, and so hopefully things aren't in too much of a mess. We have used the Resonant Rise mod pack to kind of start creating our own little kingdom. And contrary to most most things, we started in a desert. So there we go. Our home is here in the midst of this desert. It is hot. It is dry. But we're carving out a nice little place here. We kind of co-opted a tower that we found. We killed off all of the initial bandit residents and took it for our own. And so now we are continuing on, trying to eke out a life, build an ever-expanding kingdom out here in the middle of the desert. Practically on the doorstep of another kingdom. You can see in the distance, probably there's a castle over there. And so once we get to the appropriate size and strength, you know, we're probably going to go take on our neighbors, as we are a little bit of an expansionist in the Minecraft world. And so that'll be a lot of fun. Glad you could join us again. And as always, we are streaming this live, but we also are recording on our YouTube channel. And you can always watch it there. So this is, right now, twitch.tv/lastgengamers. But you can find us on the T-Bowick YouTube channel. Which is, of course, my name in Minecraft. That's me, T-Bowick. Hey, hiya. So today, I think, you know, last time I was on, it was right before I was just about to finish up. We had a couple of NPC farmers that we had built. Well, one was a farmer, and one was a forester. And unfortunately, somehow a zombie got inside and killed them both. But the great thing about the NPCs here with the Resonant Rise and the Ancient Warfare mod pack is that we have a death list. And here they are, and Ronald, the farmer, and Ronnie, the lumberjack. They can both be resurrected, and so we have got to create a priest NPC and set his home there, and hopefully he will be able to bring back our dearly departed Rons. Hey, Bowick, do you even remember why initially we called them Ron, or variations on the name Ron? Hello? Okay, Abauk is doing something else. We'll talk to her later. You may also notice I created some gold chests, which will hold so much more than these nasty old wood chests, which is fantastic. And we can actually turn those into diamond chests and maybe even crystal chests at some point in the near future, when we have enough of those resources to do that. As you can see, though, we made quite a bit of a jaunt into the Nether and came back with tons of Nether ore, which is fantastic because it is a little harder to find it here in the overworld. And threw it in our smeltery, and man, we got it going here. 272 ingots of molten copper just waiting to be turned into blocks and stored. And then a little bit of molten, I can never say that word, whatever it is, blah, 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 blah. Minialin. But anyway, you see I made a Minialin pickaxe, which is fantastic. It's got a mining speed of 9, and can pretty much mine through any material other than bedrock and a few other things. Then, of course, I've got my Alamite's longsword here, cleverly named Alamite Longsword. I also made a Bowick enough. I made a Minialin pickaxe head, a Minialin tool rod, She just has to make the cross piece to whatever she wants to make that. And then I also made a Miniland hammerhead and a rough tough rod, which are some of the components for making the Tinker's Construct hammer, which can be very, very handy for mining. We just would need a more Miniland to do the large plate casts, or whatever material we're going to use to do the large plate casts for that hammer. I don't know if we would want to use something other than Manialin. There are a lot of other materials that have interesting properties that might work better for that. But I like my pick so far. And I've still got 4 modifiers I can put on it. Things that can make it mine much faster. That can increase the durability, that can make it auto-smelt, so that when I mine ore, it automatically smelts it. Or I can make it self-repairing. I can give it luck. I can do all kinds of great things. So, I made my pickaxe out of a Manialin pickaxe head, a Manialin toolbar, and a paper cross piece. Because that paper gives it the extra modifier. So you can, you know, you can make it self-repairing, plus auto-smelt, plus fortune, plus durability. Which is a great combo. Oh, nice. Got a chicken. You know, the auto-smelt, I'm not sure I like anymore. The last mod pack I used, the Tinker's Construct with... I think they had changed it, so you couldn't actually have fortune and auto smelt. I think they made them incompatible with each other. I'm not sure, because that used to be amazing. You could have it automatically smelt into ingots, and using fortune, so you get multiple ingots from each piece of ore, which made it worth it for sure. But it hasn't been able to do that the last time I tried, so I don't know if they changed that in this mod pack or not. Or if it's an updated Tinker's Construct thing. I don't know. But we don't really have a whole lot of resources to modify it at this point, so I'm not really too worried about it. I think the first thing I'd want to do would be... I think it's redstone. Yeah, I think it's redstone that increases the speed. The mining speed. And so just so it mines faster, that would be the equivalent of efficiency. I think if you were going to try to enchant it... But I don't know that you can enchant Tinker's Construct tools, so there you go. All right, so we need a priest here. I'm not sure what we would need to research for that to happen. So let's grab our research book. We'll throw it here in the research table. I say my research book. This is obviously A. Bowick's book, looks like. I don't think Balak's got as much research as I do. So let's see if we can find my book in here. Swap them out. And check our research queue. No, I guess she does. She has more, mining, conscription, the wheel, construction, mathematics... Yeah, let's go with hers. Looks like it has more researched. So I've already made the book you would need for the priest. Just need to make the food pack, I think, and grab a few gold bars. As I am trying to remember, let's go back here. We'll do ancients. Well, if I can spell it. Priest, where are we? Here we go. So for a priest, yes, we need the food bundle, the book, and 2 gold ingots. So, let's see what we need for this food bundle. So, I have an apple. We're gonna need some pork, which I think we gave it all to one of our, fellow streamers. We were on their server. So water, so when you're gonna need water. So we have the pork and have the apple. Hey, Balak is telling me we have some, or we had some water bottles somewhere. So we need 2 steak and a cooked chicken. Alright. That's probably the first animal farm we need to do is that chicken. And then the cows, because, you know, we need leather and we need steak. So, yeah, I don't see a chicken. Cooked chicken. So we're gonna need to go find one. Alright. Alright, chicken. Alright. We've got an adult chicken here. I hate to kill our chicken. But we're gonna have to do it. Farewell, chicken. Thank you for sacrificing your life so that others may live. Let's see. Let's cook this chicken. Alright, Abalik dropped off some steak for us. So we just need that water bottle. Alright, we gotta go grab some sand. Well, actually, we have some sand up here, don't we? Somewhere. There we go. Sandstone, sand. Here we go. We'll throw some of that into the furnace here. Throw some in the furnace here. And soon enough, we'll have enough for some water bottles. Sand, why aren't you? Oh, that's sandstone. Well, that was silly. I grabbed sandstone instead of sand. Alright, we'll just grab this 21. Split it up here. Now, Abalik, we have some other NPCs available, correct? We still have 3 generic available NPCs that haven't been used. I think we probably need to create some animal farms. I would say the chicken, I mean, we're going to need chicken, pork, and beef, but, so, whichever ones are available. We have some single-use safari nets here as well, 3 of them, in this upstairs chest, and I think we can create more of them pretty easily. Do we have a ghast tier? Do you know? I don't think we do. Because we can make a reusable safari net with 4 enderpearls and a ghast tier. Yeah, we have 4 of them up here, but you can only use them once. They disappear when you use them. So I guess we could grab 2 chickens and 2 cows with it to start a farm. Yeah, we can make more safari nets if we need to. Or we can make a, let's see, can you make a leads? So we can find animals and bring them back? No. There are no leads. Let's try leash. No leash. No. There was a lead back in the moon quest. Which that we played earlier. Oh, we need to start an enchantment table too. I'm up to level 41 now. Yeah, so... Oh, man. What a drag. I just... accidentally poured 2 ingots of Manuelin into the casting basin. So... I guess I can melt some more and make a block out of it. If I have enough to do that. Yes, for sure. Alright, well, throw them in there and... I did not hit them. Alright, so we have the water bottles, so I don't need to make them, is what you're saying. I have this glass for nothing. We can always use glass, though. So, I'll just grab the rest of it. And we'll put it somewhere else. Yeah, I think 2 farms would be best. Eventually we're going to want 3, but, you know, 1 for each of the type of animals we need to make NPCs. Yeah, go ahead and make 3 then. Are you down here at the table? Oh, I was going to say, I see your stuff in there, but I don't see you. I thought maybe you were invisible. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and put the things for the priest in the chest. Yeah, I got the chicken. No, I didn't want to mess your stuff up in the, table. Where did I put all the Thaumcraft? Oh, it's downstairs, first floor. Oh, the book. I didn't need the book. You got a book down there? Yeah, I put the book in the chest just now. What's all done? Oh, well, I put it all in there for you. Okay, I'll pick it all back up. I guess I need 2 gold bars. I'm gonna go grab those. What? Yes. But you need to select it if you haven't. You did, okay. Great. And there's 9 ingots left, so 1 more block. Yep. Let's see, I guess no ingots of gold, only blocks. That's all right. We got all that gold from the nether. What? The block of Manuelin? Okay. It does. This is so money, it has a dollar sign on it. Nice. That's pretty awesome. Clever. Alright, let's see. We need a food pack, which I don't remember. Let's see. 2 steaks. Like a pork chop. And an apple. I don't know what it is, so we're gonna look it up. I hate that it doesn't work in this table. Oh wow, we're gonna need another chicken. Alright, we're gonna need another chicken. So we need a chicken for the food pack, and we need a chicken for the, this is crazy. What is it doing? So we need a chicken for the food pack, and I think we need one for the priest as well. Stuff was already in there, and it was showing up in there, and I thought it was part of the recipe, but it was just sitting in there. Okay, so we have a priest NPC now. Which is fantastic. There's Ronald. He's back. Yes. Hey, Ronald. And Ronnie. Right on, priest. Let's give you a name. All right, Father Holyoke. And we need the tools for our NPCs again. So what was it? It was an axe and a and a hoe, right? Of course, I don't know where they are. Maybe I put them downstairs where we make NPCs. Our NPC making underground room. Yes. Axe. Hoe. Nice. You know, I wonder if there's anything you're supposed to give the priest. Holy water, yeah? I don't know. Alright, Ronnie. Ronnie was our hatchet man. There you go. Lumberjack Ronnie. And where's Ronald? Do you have any ideas? Where'd you go, Ronald? Are you inside? No? Hiding amongst the... Oh, he's under... He's down on the bottom here. Looking up. All right. Well, Ronald, here is your hoe. Farmer Ronald. Nice. All right, man. Go to town. All right, he's working the wheat field. Yeah. Oh, lots of carrots. Let's take some of those. Nice, lots of hemp. We can put them anywhere we want. I would say the only place we really have room is probably over here. Yeah, we're probably going to need to expand a little bit here. Ooh, there's a chicken. He's got to be ours. Chickens don't wander around the desert. Which direction do we want to expand is the question. I don't think so. So we want to expand our territory towards the castle. Towards the east, huh? That's not towards the castle, that's... No, it's northwest of us. No, it's northwest. It is northwest. The castle. The castle I'm looking at. Castle in the desert? Is that the one you're... Alright, so there's another castle? Oh, you mean the broken castle? Oh, I thought you meant the active one. Okay. Yeah, alright, so where we originally started out and decided to come over to the tower. Yeah, I think expanding south is probably a good option. Well, we're going to need to either use that oil or fill it in anyway. So we could go that direction. I think it'd probably be easier, though, to go south. Well, then we've got this giant chasm to the south, though. Which is not a bad thing, just a thing. Let's go east. That will kind of balance us out, because we've gone quite a bit west to the western side of our castle, right? Our tower. So if we go east, then it's kind of putting the castle in the middle of our territory. Well, do we want to access it? I don't know if this is oil or if this is sludge. I don't actually know what this is. Yeah, grab a bucket and let's see if we can figure out what this black viscous liquid is. And I probably need to go make a shovel and use it to clear, to level out the terrain and let's see. It wouldn't be a bad thing. We could actually make a stairway down and just move our fence along with it. Of course, we're going to need a lot more fence, too, which means we're going to need to go to our cobblestone generator. All right. Hey, Balky's got a bucket. She's going to dip into this. It is oil. Okay. I wonder how deep it goes, or if it's just that, this pool of it. Like, you know, a lot of oil kind of goes deep underground. Okay. So kind of leave it as a pool. Yeah, I don't know any reason why we would need it, but you never want to get rid of a resource that you might need later entirely. Alright, well, there are several things we're going to need for this venture. What are you hanging around the door for, Ronnie? Lumberjack Ronnie? Alright. Okay, I'm gonna go make... Well, you are just working away, Ronald. You are in my way, Ronnie. Okay, I need to make a shovel. I think I might make one of that out of alumite. Because I've got... Oh, you used the, No, that's fine. Actually, what I'll do is maybe make an excavator. Yeah. Excavator's a broad digging tool that harvests soil and snow in a wide range. So it's a 3x3. So that can be really helpful in terms of getting a bunch of sand up and then leveling out the terrain. So, we're going to need an excavator head, the big sign face, the tough binding, and the tough rod is what it looks like, which actually will require quite a few ingots. I don't think we have enough ingots. We only got 6 alumite ingots. Hate to use Manuelin for that. I'm definitely going to go for Alomite. Alomite is pretty tough. It's a fairly renewable. In other words, it doesn't take crazy things to make it. Although it does take obsidian. How do you make Alomite? Do you remember? I know it has aluminum, copper, and obsidian. Or aluminum, tin, and obsidian. Obsidian, iron, and aluminum. We don't actually have a lot of aluminum. We actually have very little aluminum. So maybe Alomite is not the right. Well, I guess I'll just use iron. What is, let's see, what is brass? Bronze. Sorry, what's bronze? Is it tin and aluminum? It probably is. Or iron and... tin and copper. We have tons of copper. We have quite a bit of tin as well. So that'll be good. I think that's more durable than iron, if I recall correctly. Alright, so let's, 1 tin for 3 copper. So let's grab some of those copper blocks. Where are they? There we are. So 3 blocks of copper, 1 block of tin should do it. Alright, we have the cobblestone generator in the basement, is that what you're talking about? You can. That seems like it'd be the easiest way to get cobble, but you can get it from just digging. Whatever you'd prefer. Ooh, I'm hungry. Eat some potatoes. Alright, I'm gonna need... let's see. I need the tough binding rod, tough cast, large plate, and the... uh-oh, there we are. Excavator head. I thought maybe we were missing it. Obviously, we're also going to need not the casting basin here, but the casting table. Throw that down. And a little bit left on our bronze. Interesting. I don't know if the tin melts faster or if I just threw it in there before the aluminum or before the copper so much. Alright. 36 ingots of molten bronze. So let's. You know, is there anything else that I want to use for the tough binding that might give it a better durability? No, I think I'll just go with the bronze. Straight up bronze. Alright, excavator head. Wow, which takes a lot. Interesting. The... heavy plate. Tough tool rod. And a tough binding. Nice. And that left us with 14 ingots of bronze, 9 of which we'll put in here. Alright, let's get to the tool forge and construct our excavator. Okay. Mining speed is going to be 8. Durability, boy, that's still really low. But we have modifiers, so we can always make it more durable if we need. There we go. We have a bronze block. And grab those 2 ingots out of here, just so they're not sitting in there. Go ahead and grab those 2 copper ingots as well. I don't know why I said 2, I guess it was 5. Alright, and our smeltery is now clear. We're running pretty low on lava fuel, but, you know, we'll go ahead and start out something else in here, smelting. 10. Lots of tin. Get it in there. Run out of lava before that's done. But here we go. Are you out mining? Okay. Is there a zombie over here? It's daytime, zombie. You should be dead. Let me help. Okay, so I'm gonna want to extend our fence this way, like quite a bit. That's gonna be a lot of cobble. It's also gonna need a lot of sand to kind of balance out the terrain here. Unless we just want to make a stairway and go ahead and go down another level. I think let's do that, because it'll keep it with the natural level of the terrain down here, and it'll move it closer to the bottom level of this ruined castle. That way we may eventually want to encompass. So... excavator is awesome. That's kind of annoying. Actually, I guess we'll need to go down one more level here, huh? Alright. That's not so great. I think I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the magnet. This excavator is so much faster than just digging it out with a shovel. Oh my gosh, what happened there? Gotta hate those miniature Endermen. Yeah, I can come help. Where are you? Where were you mining? Ooh, look at all those apples. Aha. What? Oh. This is not one that blows stuff up though, right? Okay. Black cussed him. Yeah. That's weird, he didn't teleport me. Where did you go? Down farther? Oh. Are you just keep going down? Is that where I should? Alright, I'm at the bottom and I can take a long hallway to the right or... Yep. Oh, I think I see your experience. Yes, I do. And there's your gravestone. All right. Here's some. There's an Endermini and a zombie. All right. I have your I have a few of your things. Here's your Minimalba pick and a Yellowite pick. Some boots. What else? Here's some carrots just in case you need food. I think everything else is mine. Torches? I heard it. Okay, you all good? What is that? Oh, those are the... Okay. Yep. Where's the way out? Okay. Oh, got it. All right. Oh, it's night outside. I should probably sleep. Here at the entrance to the mines so that I don't end up running outside and dying. Not if you don't look at him, maybe? I don't know how Ender Minis respond. Whoa. Unnecessary. Whoops. Okay, let's see. I find it kind of odd. This is still... These must be source blocks. Stay out of the lava if you can. I'm still mystified by this. Is it decreasing or... Yes, it is. Very slowly. Okay, well, let's see how this does. Okay, I think that's contained. And that this will slowly disappear. Wow. Okay. Of how this might look. I wonder if Ronnie and Ronald, they keep trying to get into our house. So, do you think maybe they're being scared by mobs? And they quit working and try to get to the house? No, I don't think their tools run out. Cobblestone wherever. Let's see. I think I'm going to try to leave a 2. I love how quickly this mantle in mines, particularly soft materials like this sandstone. Okay, let's see. I think we'll try to bring the fence out to here. Which means we might as well leave this the same level. I think we might try doing these animal pins in a step. That will bring it down slowly to heading to the natural terrain level. I do want to get rid of this. Oh, maybe zombies. They're coming for me. Time to run inside and sleep. It would have been nice if you would sleep for me, but I'll run inside instead. Oh, you know what? Before we did that, I should have maybe asked you to check out the light level all the way around our place to see if we could figure out where that zombie had come from before. He's dead. Alright, did you get enough cobblestone? Okay, that's good. Make some fence out of it and or wall or whatever it's called. And come out and we can talk about how we're gonna place it. This way. Okay, well, I was figuring we would break down this eastern wall and then extend it out to... Well, that's what I'm going to do, yes. Essentially to the like here. And then cut across this way and then go to the front. Square it off with the front. You know what I mean? And to here. Yeah. I mean, you could have one going over the edge of the oil, I guess. That will necessitate having to move the whole wall on this side, but yeah. Oh, okay. All right. Sure. You got something good? Cool. Yep, but you gotta wait till I finish this layering, I think. Or you'll just have to keep moving it. I'm not filling in all the stuff I'm doing layering. Steps. That would essentially be it. So it's like four blacks per level. And I was thinking of doing the same coming out this way. Yeah, it's not gonna... That wouldn't leave us much land for the farms. Okay. So we can bring this sand down some. No? Yeah. So we can just bring the whole wall down. All right, take down this wall. Yeah, I think yes. We can just drop it off. Mm-hmm. I still don't know what I'm gonna do with managing the transition between the heights here, really. Actually, you know what? I think I'm just gonna take the sand down all the way, right as it comes off this, as it comes off the pool. Yeah, I think so. We skipped. Yeah, I think we'll probably just do stairs. The carpenter's door allows you to make it really any material you want. Okay. So now we'll just need to get some steps. I feel like I had some more, are they down here? Sandstone steps. I think I had some sandstone steps earlier that I had used and had some extras. Oh, only three. Well, three is three. Okay, we got some raw pork chops. We will cook those puppies. Okay, some apples. Put those in there. Alright, so we got a few steps. So we'll just make some more up here in our crafting table. I'm sure I have enough. Let's see, do I have enough sandstone to do that? Sandstone. 51. Yeah. That didn't work out quite so well. Alright, 23. I think that'll probably do it. If not, we'll just come in and make some more. Oh, that didn't work out so well. Why are you being upside down? There. Okay. We got the steps down here. Should we put some more back here, probably? I would think so, right? Be too narrow, so we'll do that. Oh, one step short. Unacceptable. I sure am hungry. Hey, Ronald, what are you doing, farmer? Let's go grab some carrots, maybe? From... No. Oh, wow. Oh, I'll just use my baked potatoes. We do need to take some of those, though, probably... cook them. So let's grab the stack of 63. Throw these into the furnaces. That'll have some potatoes pretty quickly. I wonder how the town hall is doing for food. I think maybe that's why these guys keep trying to get inside. Nope, they've still got 12 steak, 21 carrots, and 9 apples. And that'll keep them occupied for a little while. Carrots and the wheat are coming along nicely. Take some of those carrots, throw them in here. Yeah, I think we can, let's see, I'll make one more set of steps here with sandstone. That was a short one step on this back stairway. Oh, you know what? Actually, I kind of like the two step. As opposed to three. So we're gonna go with that. Ooh, Ronald, why are you jumping down like that, hurting yourself? He's working here at the animal farm with a hoe. Ronald, what are you doing, man? This wall, it's It's like one, two, it's three. Three sections of wall between each, like little area that pokes up. It's like put an extra, or you can give them to me and I'll do it. Because the torches go on there, on top of those. This is too many. Oh, I see. It's, go, let's see, one, two, three, and then four here. So torch there. One, two, three, four. Sorry. There we go. And what we got here? Say one, two, six. So it's going to be weird no matter what. That's okay. Aesthetics are only half the battle. I don't know. I don't know whether the floodlight... I don't know what the floodlight requires. That feels like something that would require electricity, though. I have never used the immersive engineering mod, so I'm not real sure. We can make everything in the immersive engineering mod? Oh, we can. Oh, we have the components to make a floodlight. Got it. Yeah, I don't know. It to me, it feels like something that would need some kind of power source. I think I might need more torches. Crap. Not fast enough. Okay, that's pretty good. Got a pretty good covering of, still doesn't get that, huh? All right. Okay, so let's see. We need to get probably some. You know, actually, we could use that. We could use the cobblestone fence that you have to surround these animal pens. I wonder if I can make them any bigger. Yeah, no, I can't make them any bigger. They are what they are. So I'm gonna move over one. Well, it leaves the gap in between the fence here, which is not horrible, but if animals... Yeah. Ooh. No. They don't need to get in there. They just work at the station there. I'm out. Oh, unless they run off the cliff like that. Come on, Ronald. Bro, that's ridiculous. He's stuck now. He's just spinning in place. It's like, no, he should be able to jump over this block right here, just like the animals will be able to, actually. They can just jump from here, right? Oop. Yeah, it's just one block. So, Ronald. Repack. Great. I think that'll help. Alright, so we need to find animals to put in here. Still. You know what? Looks interesting, but I don't think that's... No, I didn't. This is what I did on the other stream was this. Keeps them from jumping in and out. Okay. So. All right. Ready to. Oh, I gotta unpack our buddy Ronnie here. Doop. Or Ronald, sorry. I'm short a few torches. Man, I got the sand. I gotta tell you, that excavator really worked well. That is what you want to use for moving massive amounts of dirt or sand. Some more potatoes you can put out there. What are you doing here, Ronald? These NPCs are not the crunchiest cookies in the jar. Let's see. I don't know if chickens can eat hemp seeds. But that's all right. I think we might want to, instead of this hemp, we might want to replant wheat. Like I think I'm going to move the Oh wow, these are all carrots now. There's no wheat. Okay, well. Whoops, I guess I need to get rid of those. I'm gonna do that. Keep getting planted. What the heck? Sweet. There we go. Let's do that. That's all wheat. And instead of hemp and potatoes, I guess we need to take that out. Great. Grab those chickens. Throw away the poisonous potatoes. And we'll do carrots and potatoes here. I guess that's what I get for jumping. Blood moon is rising. This will be interesting. Do you think our fences and all our stuff will keep all the mobs out for blood moon? Well, that's what I'm asking. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to repack up the priest, Father Holyoke. No, he'll bring them back if they... You know what I mean? Yeah, I don't think that changes, though. That's because they just got healed, I think. Like, that shows their life. I'm interested to see what happens. you can watch from inside. Nice, we got 22 apples in our tree farm. Oh, somebody's definitely shooting some arrows. Arrow! That was a good shot, too. Woo! And now they're shooting each other. I just realized let's see. Put some torches up here. So the top of that's lit up, so nothing can spawn up there. Of course, spiders can get over the wall. Do we? Oh, they're in the still in your Yeah, alright. Right? Alright, we got a good bit of tin melted in the smeltery. Let's throw some more nether tin in there. Still got a little fuel left. Might take us through. It just gets so ugly in the blood moon. This is really well done graphically. Everybody's hiding inside, Ronald, and you know, I guess we could put a door on this thing. They can open and close normal wooden doors. Lots of baddies out here. There are quite a few areas in our animal pens that don't have light. It's like a gang of zombies. Somebody killed a spider. Oh yeah, wow. That's a gang. Get away from these skeletons. A plethora of zombies. I would say they're a plethora, Evie. Lava. Oh wow, in our sugarcane there's quite a few areas where there's not enough light. Yeah. It is hilarious. You mean all the multitude of zombies? Oh, a spider made it over. He was no match for my alamite sword. Ouch. We need a bow. Do you have a bow? Just snipe at him. Oh yeah. Oh man, we've got some red spots in our inside our tower. In these little closets. In our bedroom, no less. What was that about? That is good. Thought it was inside the base. This is a helpful creeper. And we got a ton more to smelt too. There's a lot in there. I think the server crashed. Oh, all the mobs are just sitting still. Maybe I crashed. Ooh, and there's some inside. Oh no! Behind you! I've got to get down to help you. They're gonna kill. The teleportation, No, did he already kill them? No, they already killed our, they killed. There was a skeleton behind you because. Oh. Yeah, that was not so smart. That's alright, they can't get out of that hole. Thank you. did I come from? Weird. Maybe the tops of our apple trees? Well, the blood moon's going down. That was close. Oh, you know what? Up above the little area that I made for the NPCs, for the Rons, there are no lights up there. So, you're right. See, running out there into a bunch of creepers. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fill in most of these holes. I'm going to go ahead and leave some holes, though. Hello, chicken. It's not that bad to have a hole there, but should probably go ahead and deploy Priest, but I'm gonna seal this off first so he doesn't wander out. still get out, so we'll wait on putting him back out until we have it a little more controlled. I'm gonna go grab that sand I put in the chest up here and use that as our repair material. Oh, I've got so much junk though. Let's see what I can get rid of. 6 bones. Arrows. Eggs. Hang on to the helmet and give that to our NPCs. They can always use a little bit of extra armor. Dump the spider eye. What do we got? String? Nope. String? Let's see. I don't know why we have lots of sand in here. What did I just grab? Some of the sand to fill in those holes. Hopefully this will be enough. Rebuild our fence. Get our NPCs back. And we'll be good to go. Alright, let's just fill this in. Easy enough. More than that. I don't mind that big hole there. This, however, could prove troublesome. I think we'll leave a lot of it here as a testament to remind us to stay away from creepers who are close to the fence. And that will be a helpful reminder. Kind of a noob mistake, but I can certainly understand the appeal of free zombie kills. You know, we might want to fill in that other side with water. Give this sand wall a little more protection. Looks like we lost some lighting here. Let's do that. Okay. Alright, Father Holyoke. Come on back out. It's safe. Alright, now. Here we go, Ronald. And here we go, Ronnie. Ronnie, you had an axe, my friend. And let's just give you a helmet, why not? Have a helmet. There we go, and you had a hoe. And how about a helmet for you as well? And there we go. May as well go ahead and take these, turn it into string. Where did it? There we go. And three across makes a string. So, more string, yay. It did melt, wow. Alright. Couple more arrows. Oh, feathers not in here, I guess. There was a zombie head in the other one. Alright. Zombie head 3. Feather. Ah, string over here. No, string must be downstairs. Go ahead and cook the chicken. Grab the pork chops. Thought there were more. Guess not. Take those downstairs to our NPC. Oh my gosh, another blood moon is rising. 2 nights in a row. That's brutal. Pissed off. Such a harsh word. We torqued him off. Hey, Balak was noting that we must have upset someone. Because this is ridiculously brutal. 2 blood moons in a row. Let's see. I am going to put my bronze excavator back in here. Let's see. There we go. Ronnie, the 2 Ronnies and the priests are back, but of course it's another blood moon, so it might be good to either wall them up in here or to just repack them until this blood moon is over, because they're certainly not doing anything. They're just kind of cowering in their little hut here. So, may as well repack them for the time that the blood moon is out. So I think when morning comes, we're gonna restart our animal farming efforts. Which means Avalik got 2 chickens, I think, in the safari nets. And so, you know, while it's nighttime, I should probably just be making some more safari nets. Because I don't think we had enough to get all the animals that we need. So to just make the single use, is leather, slime ball, and string. Which is pretty easy. To make the reusable, we need that gas tier. Which again, we don't have. So, you know, the really only way to get that, I think, is probably killing gas in the nether, which requires, at the very least, a bow to do effectively. And so, I think we're just gonna have to stick with the single use for now. We do have some slime balls. I remember seeing some of those upstairs. Let's take a look. We've got 6, 3, 13. Let's see if we can consolidate here. I guess I don't have zombie flesh, rotten flesh anywhere, really. Just get rid of it. Okay, 13 and we've plenty, more than we need. Let's see, we have string in the ancient warfare basement. Sand. Get out of there. What? Oh wow, this is all sandstone. We'll put that away. Okay, so 13, more than enough. Where do we want to put this oil bucket? Leave it there for now. You know, I'm going to take these dark boots and put it on one of our NPCs when I bring them back. Cooked chicken. Alright, leather is what I was looking for. I know we have some downstairs as well. Which is good, because we don't have any here. Blood Moon is still going. Alright, let's see. Leather. String. Here we go. Let's make some safari nets. One, two, three, four. Four is probably enough, right? We already had four. So that'll allow us to get 2 chickens, 2 cows, and 2 pigs, right? Hey, Bauk, did you happen to research animal husbandry? Alright. Probably. Okay. Great. Fishing, conscription, machinery, and mining are our next. Aha, we need to find some method of making steel. So, we'll probably have to get into railcraft. Which I think is probably the point, since we also have to do those 6 powered, or booster rails, I think they are. Let's drop off these 10. We can drop some more of this 10 in here, even though I don't think we'll have enough lava to smelt it, actually, but that's okay. We're gonna put those industrial hemp seeds out here in the chest. Hey, spider. Skeleton riding a spider. Yeah, jumped over the wall. His crazy spider skills. To drop off that chicken downstairs as well. Cooked chicken. Part of the food pack. Okay. Alright, hey Bauk, where should I drop off the safari nets? I did. I made 4 more safari nets. Okay. So we need 2 chickens, 2 cows, and 2 pigs. You already got the 2 chickens? Okay. Beware, we do have some creepers right outside our walls. Yes. Blood Moon, I think, is over for this night. I'm sure we'll see another one. Yeah, hopefully not tomorrow night. Alright, here are the... Yes. Here are the other safari nets. Great. And then... Oh, what? Come here with your whiz-biz. Enchanted bow. That was some crazy virulent poison he threw at me. That sucker took me like all the way down. Yes, I am talking about downtown. Alright, I'm gonna go put our NPCs back to work. Alright. Here we go. Father Holyoke. Ronnie and Ronald. Here's some boots for you, my friend. And some boots for you. Slowly giving a little bit of protection to our workers. Alright, so we've got these 2 chickens down here. And we're gonna put some seed in here. Look at that. There they go. They're loving it. They already got a baby chick out. Boom. We're gonna... magnet that right up. Oh. No. There's a skeleton out front, almost killed me. Again, because I just had such low hearts because I was... I just finished almost dying. Well, we definitely need more lava, so we need the oil's in the bucket, so I'll just make another bucket, I think. We have plenty of iron, although we don't have plenty of iron ingots. That's all right. guess this, yeah, interesting. Hmm. All right. So we'll take our... What's that? Wow, you got all the animals?
Yep.
Very nice. I'm going to make another seared tank, I think. Which involves one of these, I think, in glass. So, glass. You know what? Did he somehow get into the animal pen? Well, okay. Okay, must be the opposite. Tank. Brain tank. Interesting. Portal tank. Well, there's all kinds of tanks. Ender tank. Okay. Seared tank. Okay, seared bricks around glass. Okay. Interesting. I don't know if we have enough seared bricks to do that. We have a bunch of seared blocks. Oh, we do. Good. I have 48 wheat. I took it out of there to give to the animals. Yeah. Okay, let me put back the seared bricks. Should put the glass back as well, but I'm gonna go get lava instead. First, I'm gonna go put this stuff in the animal pen so they can start getting it on. Doing what the animals do. Put half in the pig. Oh yes, Ronald. How can I fix Ronald? How did he even get in there? He must have just jumped up and over the wall with the sand, probably. Ooh, creeper. Right outside the wall, watching me. And the cows are being romantic. I do hear a baby. Oh, you know what? Maybe, do pigs not need wheat? What do pigs need? Carrots? Apples? I don't think I know. Alright. Alright, Ronald. Come on, bro. Chickens need seed. I'm stuck in here now. Use the sand. I got the chickens going. I got the cows going. The pigs, though. Oh, the pigs are going. Carrots? Very nice. Did you just put the rest of the wheat in the cow? Okay. Come on back out, Ronald. What you doing there, Ronnie? Just kind of hanging? Alright, heading down to the crevasse. Oh, I jumped down a little too soon. Trying to grab some lava. Ooh, it's hot down here. Very hot. Alright, we got lava. Enough to fuel our smeltery for a little bit. We're headed back. And this is going to be a good place to end the stream tonight, I think. After we refill our smeltery. I don't think it gets rid of everything in there when you break it. But just in case, we're going to do this manually. There we go. And then, just for kicks, we'll go refill this so that we have a backup. I came down the wrong side, huh? Well, I'll use this nicely built bridge. This will take me down where I need to go. One, two, three, four. Make sure my magnet's on. I don't want to lose this tank. And there we go. Boom goes the dynamite. And the lava is up. It's getting dark. Time to head back to the protection of faulty towers. Just pop this right up here. Why not? Nice. All right, and what's the next thing we're gonna pop in there? Plenty of silver, plenty of lead. Diamond, lapis, redstone, silver, and silver lead, lead, peridot, sapphire, mithril, ferrus, amber. And coal. Let's try, I guess, the silver. See how that does. Gotten in such a bad habit of doing that. Not actually grabbing what I want out of the chest. Looks like it's smelting, so it's a good sign. Collecting so much random junk. All right, well, it's been fun tonight. Again, thank you for hanging in, hanging out with us with Last Gen Games, where you're always the right age to game. Hope you've had fun. This has been the Resonant Rise mod pack, and we are slowly expanding our kingdom. So, tonight we actually got to move our borders out a little bit. We got some animal farms going, which is going to be great for helping us be self-sustaining. Where is the baby pig? There they are. All right. So it's going to help us be more self-sustaining and be able to build more NPCs more quickly. Our kingdom is still not very beautiful. We are in a pretty dry and desolate desert wasteland, but we're doing a pretty good job of reclaiming that, making it a little more of an oasis. We've got our crops going here and our NPCs working on those. We've got our tree farm over here where they also work, and then we've got a little apple orchard back here, and that'll be it for tonight. We're slowly expanding, having fun, and we will see you again on another stream very soon.